Welcome to another edition of Women Lead TV. I'm Michelle Bergquist, your host today, and with me, I'm so excited, is Stephanie Blue. She's the owner of TRUE BLUE Portrait and one of our sponsors in Connected Women of Influence. Stephanie, say hello to all of our audience.
Hello.
We're here today to talk about branding and how your image and what comes through, I think we're going to say, can either make it or break it for us as professionals. Is
Definitely.
That correct?
Yes.
So tell us a little bit of how the brand works when it comes to the visual, and especially today with social media. It's a big deal.
It is a big deal.
Yeah.
So part of it is, it's not just the headshot, because people are scrolling and swiping, and if your images and your visual marketing isn't grabbing their attention, they're strolling and swiping right on by to your competition.
Well, I'm loving that. And what can someone do to make sure that as people are swiping and liking and passing you, what are some things that could help someone stand out in a good way? Because I know there's ways to stand out in a bad way, but what would be some good tips for someone?
Well, that professional...
I'm feeling nervous now. I'm going to, I got to look professional.
So, it's the wardrobe. It's tying in your brand colors. It's bringing that message forward. It's not a dull headshot that just looks like you, like the DMV will do for you. It's about pulling out that personality with the photographs that really capture someone's attention and make them want to get to know you, make them want to do business with you.
I'm curious, because I know you are fabulous about making people uncomfortable at the time you're photographing them, and they turn out so great. Uncomfortable. And you don't realize until you see the photo then later that it's like you're looking for something. I mean, how do you, what are some maybe some things you do to be able to kind of capture that with people? You have us twist in different ways, and it just comes through fabulously on, on the photograph.
Part of it is the posing and the lighting and just getting you in a position that I know is going to look best on camera. But also putting you at ease, especially when you see the back of the camera, that, yeah, that worked, and we're going to just keep going with that.
I like that. Tell us a little bit about your journey as a photographer, and now I know you're kind of getting into this whole, you have to love that social media has only changed the game for you. Has it been a good, like, ride that this is such a, not even a trend anymore? I mean, this is it. Social
media
is crazy. Everybody's online. We either look great or we don't. It either supports us as our brand or doesn't.
Right.
But for you, what, you know, how did you even get into photography? I'm dying to know.
I've loved it since I was a kid. I got my first camera at 10.
Oh, wow.
Took crazy photos all through all the vacations, and then really got back into it roughly 10 years ago. And through networking, it's the business branding that kind of took off, because I work with fabulous, or network with fabulous women. But the
keep talking about that.
So fabulous. But the social media plays a huge role, because people see each other. And if you think about, if you see an advertisement for a burger that looks fantastic and you see one that looks quite scary, you know, which one are you going to go to? Which one will you take, invest your time and money and your tummy in, and it's going to be the better photo. So when you are representing your own business, you don't want to kind of DIY it with the cell phone in the backyard that your kid takes. You really do need to invest in professional photos that are going to bring out that personality and that message.
I love that. I mean, because we've got LinkedIn, Facebook, all of that, you know, and we're here for an association of professional women, so we want to keep things professional. What would be, I mean, again, and I know you can go out and people should hire you. It's a good idea to hire a professional, but let's say somebody is a do-it-yourselfer and they you know, want to kind of keep things very cost-effective. What would be some suggestions for you and what someone could do if they want to have someone help them take photos so they come across better as a brand?
Well,
lighting, background.
Lighting is definitely key. You do need to have some good lighting. Professional makeup helps a lot because the camera grabs it as is.
Yes. You sold me on that. I was like, no, I can do my own. No.
Right. And you don't want a lot of distractions in the background either.
Okay.
So
nothing like this?
This could work. But
critique
but
it for me, girl.
Well, the gaps would be a little bit of a problem, but otherwise the pattern's not bad.
Okay.
And of course you got the Connected Women
of Influence.
I
know that, right? We got that.
Yes.
I love it.
So those are my three tips.
I want to know for you, what is it like working with clients that push back a little bit when you tell them, look, these are the things I'm looking for? I know that was my experience, and I was like, I think your words to me at the time were trust the process. Trust what I'm going for. So what is it like, you know, to kind of go through and do a photography shoot when someone's pushing back, you know, a little bit? How do you?
I have very few people that push back.
Okay.
Typically, they come as referrals, or they've seen my work already. And if they want that look, and that's what I say, if you want it to look like what you see and what you like and the reason you called me, then let's go with the process.
Just, you're so quiet mannered about that. You're like, I'm in charge.
Right.
And there's no questions
yes.
here.
I wear my bossy britches from time to time.
You can't stand up right now, but
no.
She does have on the bossy britches, so everybody knows.
Right.
You know, I'm dying to know for you, it's like, what do you see as the future of photography? I mean, everything's so hot right now with video. Photography has changed a lot, mm-hmm. right? I mean, I remember the old dark rooms and stuff
yes.
like that. I'm sure you do, because mm-hmm. You're a photographer. I'm not. I just played with it. But what are some like future things that you see with photography that are either exciting to you or a little concerning as what changes or what might change?
Yeah. Well, video definitely does play a role with people, especially if you have a story or a process that you can show through video. But as far as every day, I think a lot of people, they want to just glean through their social media feeds, and not all of them will take the time to press play on the video. So I don't think the photography is going anywhere. And in fact, there's all kinds of behind the scenes things that you can do with cell phones, your everyday stuff as the life of an entrepreneur or even a corporate person, to just kind of show what it's like. And people really love to know that because it gives them a little glimpse of your story mm-hmm. and what it's like to do business with you or to be you.
I like that. Yeah. I like that. For you, what's the future look like for you? I'm really curious. It's like, you know, are you looking to build an empire? Are you...
Global domination.
I am all about that world domination. Yes, I am.
Yes.
It's like, please, chief empire builder, right?
Yes.
It's good. What's the future look like for you? I mean, as far as your business and what mm-hmm. you're trying to do, if you can share.
Sure. Just doing more of the branding that really ties in. I love working with people that don't have, like, just a cookie cutter job, mm-hmm. but maybe they're a life coach or a health coach or someone who wants to bring out something unique about them. And so really tailoring the session yeah. and conceptually figuring out what it is about their personality or how they do business, or mm-hmm. maybe it's tying in their hobby or something that makes them them, uh-huh. and then bringing that out visually.
That's pretty cool. You've done that with me, I got to admit. It's like, you know, the moderating podium thing. I didn't ever yeah. think that would work out well for me, but it really did. You know, I mean, I think this might, we weren't planning to talk about this, but I know you do a lot of giving back, and mm-hmm. there's like a very special heart-centered project that you're working on.
Yes.
Do you mind sharing it with
sure.
our audience and letting them know this is very heart-centered for you, and I know you're in the stages of getting it done.
Mm-hmm.
What is the project?
The project I'm working on is with my makeup artist. It's a book of inspirational women mm-hmm. and telling their stories. So our goal is to have 75 women. We're over halfway done.
Yay.
And they will have a photo shoot and makeover, but it's really pulling out, they will have their story in there too with what it is that they overcame. And we're talking major things that most people would curl up in a ball and just shrivel up. Mm-hmm. And these women have not done that. They've survived, they're thriving, and they're inspiring others with their story. And then really kind of pulling out what is it that they held on to get up and every single day go out there and shine.
Your heart comes through when you
it
talk
does.
About it. And so for our audience, if mm-hmm. anybody is looking to either know about it mm-hmm. or reach out to you, do you want to share how you want to be connected?
They can reach me through Stephanie@TrueBluePortrait.com.
Okay.
Stephanie with an F.
Spell it S-T.
S-T-E-F-A-N-I-E @TrueBluePortrait.com. Mm-hmm. And just ask about the inspiration project.
Love it. One final thing. Are you ready for my one big question?
Yes.
Okay, be ready.
I am nervous.
It's a power question. You should be. No, I'm just teasing. Because I didn't tell you this, but I'm like, leave us with something that will inspire us or make us feel good about what you do and who mm-hmm. you are. And I know I'm freaking you out, but just leave us on a high note, because you've got so
yeah.
much in you and you are so talented. I want mm-hmm. you to know that. And I appreciate working
yeah.
with you. So,
One of my life guiding principles is beauty is everywhere. And mm-hmm. I think a lot of times women don't embrace that, or they're camera shy, and really just yeah. trusting yourself and believing in yourself and embracing that.
Whoa, that's pretty awesome. Thank you for being
You're
on
really
Women
welcome.
Lead TV.
Thank you
to our audience. We'll be back again with another Women Lead TV show.